क्लास सिक्स टॉप सब्जेक्ट ज्योग्राफी एंड द टॉपिक इज द टेम्परेचर। आई एम प्रशांत भोसले फ्रॉम द सिद्धार्थ नगर म्यूनिसिपल इंग्लिश स्कूल। आवर टॉपिक इज अ फिफ्थ टॉपिक टेम्परेचर। व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय द टेम्परेचर? कैन एनीवन टेल?
हेलो
सर,
हेलो
टेम्परेचर इज हॉट और कोल्ड, वी इज कॉल्ड इट एज टेम्परेचर।
एनी ऑब्जेक्ट वी कैन से इट इज हॉट और कोल्ड, बट व्हेन वी हैव टू कंपेयर बिटवीन मेनी ऑब्जेक्ट और एक्सप्रेस हाउ मच हॉट एंड हाउ मच कोल्ड, देन वी हैव टू यूज अ प्रॉपर क्वांटिटी। For that, the temperature is a physical quantity that express hotness and the coldness of a object. For example, our body temperature is 37 degrees Celsius. Now there are the three pictures. First picture is from the North Pole, second picture is on the equator, and third picture from the South Pole. Like that, on the polar region we feel a cool temperature, and on a equator we feel the hot temperature. Why the north and south pole having ice and cool temperature? Why equator having dry and hot temperature? Why on the earth there are the different places having a different temperature, although we are living on the earth? So all that questions we will get the answer in this chapter. So let's start one activity. Take a torch light and keep it stable on a one place. Take a two large sheets large enough to accommodate its entire beam. Place the paper on a two flat board. Now hold the board perpendicular to the beam. Draw the outline of the area lit up by the beam. Name the paper A. Now use the other paper. Hold it a such way that it makes an angle of 120 degree with the beam. Draw the outline of the area occupied by the beam. Name the paper B and observe the both paper. Now tell me, on which paper does the beam occupy a larger area?
So second paper.
Second. The beam occupy a larger area on the paper that is held in a such way that it makes an angle of 120 degree with the beam. A paper, you saw the paper is in the perpendicular, means into the 90 degree angle, and the paper B having 120 degree angle, so it is a little bit slant. That's why light is taking a more larger area. Now on which paper is the area smaller? Can anyone tell?
A.
Sorry? Hello?
Yes, sir. First one.
The area is larger on the paper that is held in a such way that it makes an angle of 90 degree, that means perpendicular with the beam. The paper A having a smaller area. Now tell me, now change the angle between the beam of a light and the paper and observe the changes that occurs in the area occupied by the beam of a light. If we change that paper into the different angle, more than 90, so we will get, the light is getting more and more area. What is the relation between angle of the paper and the area occupied by the beam? When the angle of a paper with the beam is a less degree, the area occupied the beam is a smaller. Look, on the first paper we have a 90 degree area, and on the B paper we have 120 degree area. So on the first paper it is a smaller degree angle, that's why it is occupying a smaller area. On the other hand, when the angle of a paper with the beam is of a more area, more degree, the area occupied by the beam is a larger. That's why on the B paper it is having a more angle, like 120 degree angle, so it is occupied the more area. Now why we do this activity, let's get the explanation. All of you know that we are getting a heat and light from the sun. Sun rays coming towards the earth travel in a straight line. However, as the earth is into the spherical shape, these are not a perpendicular to all the parts of the earth's surface. Now we getting a perpendicular line, perpendicular sun rays, but due to the our earth is into the spherical shape, so the unequal distribution was done. In some part they are perpendicular, where in the other part they are slanting. Let's see the effect of it on the earth. The perpendicular rays occupies less area. The part where the sun rays occupies lesser area receive the bright sunshine and a greater heat. Hence the surface get heated more and the air become a hot. Now when the land is very hot, the air which is touched to the land, it become a hot. That's why their temperature is also high. The slant area, slant rays occupies a larger area. In this area the sunlight appear less bright and there is a less heat. Due to the larger area, the sunlight occupy larger area. Due to that, what will happen? It get a less heat. Hence, the surface there get a less heated, and air too is less hot. Due to the less, the temperature of the land is very less. So why the air is also having a coolness. The region marked A in the figure 5.2 receive the perpendicular rays, while the region marked B received a slant rays, and in the region marked C the rays are extremely slant. Now you have observed that there are the sun and the earth. There are the three rays are coming, A, B and C. On the equator we have a rays, and on the north pole we have a C, and in the middle of north pole and equator we have a B. So using a scale, measure the length of the tip of a portion on the earth's surface is A, B and C. You have to use a scale and measure which rays occupying a more area. The measure the width of the rays shown between the earth and the sun. Considering the parallel of the latitude marks in the figure, tell the region where the temperature will be the high, moderate and low. The temperature will be high in the region receiving perpendicular rays. Now on the equator we have a A rays, which is a perpendicular in the perpendicular. So why there is the temperature is very hot. The temperature will be the moderate in the region receiving a slant sun rays. The temperature will be low in the region receiving extremely slanting sun rays. Now on the B rays, where it is fall on the earth, the B rays is a little bit slant. So why their temperature is little bit cool, but in the sun the rays C in that it is fall on the north pole, which is occupying a larger area, and it is extremely slant. So why their temperature is very low. Now why we done this activity, let's get an explanation. Sun rays following on the earth are straight and parallel to each other. However, we have seen that due to the spherical shape of the earth and the resultant the curvature of the surface, they occupy larger or lesser area. This lead to the unequal distribution of the heat received from the sun, resulting in the decreasing temperature from the equator to the north and south pole. Based on the description of temperature, distribution of the temperature, the earth can divide it into three types: torrid, temperate, and polar region. Now you have seen that that two figures. On the first, it is following on the equator, so why it is hot, and that is called torrid. On a B, where B is following on the earth, there are the little bit low temperature, so why it is temperate. And on the polar region, it is following in a very extremely slant, so why it is having a low temperature. Though the latitude is the main factor. Latitude means what? Can anyone express latitude? We have learned that in the previous lesson. Okay.
Latitude means
lines, which is
that line globe that comes to
lines,
north pole to south pole.
Identify the place or find out the particular place. Now you have seen that there are the horizontal line and vertical lines. The vertical lines is known as the latitude. The horizontal line is known as a latitude. So the latitude is a main factor. There are other factors also which influence the distribution of the temperature. Not only the latitude, but also there are other factors which influence the temperature of a particular region. However, their effects are limited to a particular region. These factors are nearest to the sea. Now the length between the two places from the sea, it is also having a determine the temperature of that particular area. Continentality means where we have a mountains, where we have a plateau, that also affect our temperature. Height above the mean sea level and the physical setup of a region are the factor that lead to the diversity in the climate of a different region. Now the height from the sea level of that particular place, the place is on a mountain, so it's high, having a high height, so their temperature is low. But the place is lower than the sea level, then it is having a high temperature like a plateau. Other than these, the factor like a cloud covering. Now in the Mumbai, you have observed that due to the cloud, we feeling a coolness. wind. The wind which is blowing everywhere. If the wind is cool, then we getting a temperature cold. Vegetation cover. Vegetation cover means what? There, if there is any forest near to your place, then also due to the maximum the plants sending oxygen in the atmosphere, so we getting a coldness. Urbanization. Urbanization means what? Where the most cities are there. In the cities, the temperature of a particular place is very high. The industrialization. Industrialization means we having the MIDC and all that. So in that MIDC, the different smokes are leaved by the various industries, and that smoke having a various gases like CO2, carbon dioxide, and it create the heat. That's why their temperature is high, etc. Are also influence the local climate. Now, how will the rays fall between 0 degree and 23 degree 30 inch north and south pole? Can anyone tell? Okay, between 0 degree and 23 degree 30 inch north and south, the sun rays are perpendicular. As its effect, this area received a bright sunlight and greater heat. Therefore, this area is known as a torrid zone. How will the rays fall between 23 degree 30 inch and 66 degree 30 inch north and south rays? Between 23 degree 30 inch and 60 degree 30 inch north and south, the sun rays are slanting. As it affect the this area receive less bright sunlight and less heat. Therefore, these areas are known as a temperate zone. How will the rays fall between 66 degree 30 inch and 90 degree north and south? Can anyone tell? Between 66 degree 30 inch and 90 degree north and south, the rays are extremely slant. As it affects, this area receive extremely less bright sunlight and extremely less heat. Therefore, these areas are known as fringed areas. Tell if the following statement is right or wrong. Give the reason. In order to understand the climate of region, latitudinal extent is more useful than the longitudinal extent. Now, latitude means the horizontal line, and longitude means it is a vertical lines. Statement is right. The reason of that statement is why it is right. The temperature does not change as per the longitudes. The longitudes are vertical lines, and the temperature are not changing with the relation of the longitudinal. The temperature change as per the latitudes. The temperature decreases from the equator to the north and south pole. Now let us perform an experiment to see that there is a difference in the heating and cooling of land and water. Take a 2 pots of the same size and fill them with water at the sunrise. Keep on this pot inside the house and other pot outside. See that it remains in the sun all the time as shown in the figure 5.4. In afternoon, walk barefoot barefoot means you do not have to wear a chappal or sandal. With the barefoot on the floor inside the house and feel the temperature of the floor. Feel the temperature of water in the pot inside. Means you have to dip your hand into the water and you have to feel the temperature. Perform the same activity outside the house and get a feel of the temperature of land and a water kept in the sun. Now you have to mention the both observation. Does this do this again around 7 in the evening? Note down your observation. Now you can remove the pots. Why we have done this activity? Because you must have realized that the land cools down earlier than the water. If you done this activity in the, you will get that in the afternoon the land is also heated. But at the 7 o'clock, when you done a second observation, you will get you will observe that that land is cooled quickly. The water kept outside in the sun is still little warmer. If you having this observation, then at the 7 o'clock in the evening, you will feel the hot temperature, the water temperature, which is kept in the sunlight. It is a little warmer. Due to this difference in the heating and cooling of land and water, the air over the land get heated faster and also become a cooler rapidly. This air over the water gets heat slowly and also loses heat in a slower manner. Now the air which is on the land, it is getting a heat very quickly and leaving the heat very quickly like a land. But the air which is on the ocean or sea, here it is become hot very slowly and it is getting a cool very slowly manner. In the coastal area, as a compare to the continental areas, the temperature of air is a lower during the day but the warmer at a night. On the contrary, the temperature of air in a continental area is higher during the day time and lower at the night time. Why this is happen? Because the on the ocean there is the water and the water heat up slowly. So while in the morning near the sea we having a little bit temperature, but in the afternoon it is very high and evening it is all it is also warmer. But in the mountain area the temperature in the morning is very low, in the afternoon it is heated, and in the evening it is become a cool very fast. So why we are having a night time the temperature is very low. Because of the heating of the sea water, the water vapor get mixed in the air. Now what happened? Due to the heating of water, the water vapor was created and the water vapor is mixed in the air. This water vapor hold the heat in the air. As a result, the air in a coastal area remains moist and warm. Now the water vapor hold the heats in the air. As a result, the air in the coastal areas remains moist and warmer. Conditions in the coastal areas are opposite. There is a lack of water. Due to that, as a water vapor is absent, the air remains dry. This leads to the sharp difference in the day and night temperature. This difference in a maximum and minimum temperature of the day is called a diurnal range of a temperature. In short, the difference in the day and night temperature is less in the coastal areas and more in the continental area. For example, the Mumbai temperature are even, but at Nagpur they are vary a lot. In the coastal region of the Konkan, range of temperature is less because the Konkan having a near Arabian Sea. But in the Vidarbha, the range of the temperature is found to be higher. Vidarbha is so far from the sea, so why it is having a temperature higher? There, coastal areas have equable climate, where in the continental areas the climate is extreme. For example, the climate of Mumbai is equable, which is same, means it is having a limited difference between the day and night. Whereas the continental location like Nagpur, it is extreme. In the day temperature, it is like 37 or 38 degrees Celsius, and in the night, it is having 26 or 24 degrees Celsius. This difference in the mean temperature of the summer and winter is called an annual range of the temperature. Now we have observed the term, that is a diurnal range of the temperature. Diurnal range means it is a difference between the day and night temperature, and the annual range of the temperature means it is a difference between the temperature in the mean of sun and summer and winter. Now, anyone have any question related to this topic? Okay, thank you. So